Dr. Pankaj Shah. He is a medical oncologist at Zydus Hospital and Vice President at Gujarat Cancer Society and Trustee. Sadvichar Parivar, Ahmedabad, Gujarat.
Dignitaries on the dais, of the dais, and those who are attending the parliament, it's a great occasion for me to be here in Pune, in this Peace University and the largest dome of the country, not of the country, but of the world. I am from Ahmedabad. It's a place where Gandhi started his ashram, and in the ashram, there was an ashram Bhajanavali in which the prayer from all religions were there. And as this part of the event is the part of celebration of 150th anniversary of Gandhi, I am very much delighted to be part of it. The Pune is also very important to Gandhi, because most of his part of prison were spent in Pune. He lost his wife and he lost his secretary Mahadev Desai in Pune. So Pune is also a pilgrimage place for me, and now I have added this dome as my another pilgrimage for the Pune. Let me start. In 2013, the world celebrated like this only, 158th year anniversary of Swami Vivekananda. On that time, in the seminar, there was a chapter on the science and religion, which was written by S.C. Majumdar. The definition of science in this particular seminar was, the word science is derived from the Latin word scientia and the French word sciare, meaning know, knowledge. It is a branch of knowledge conducted on the objective principle, involving systematized observation of an experiment with phenomena actually concerned with the material functions of the physical universe. And we all know what science has done to the humankind. Now the word religion, in that seminar it is written, religion is derived from the Latin word religuns, meaning obligation, bond, reverence. Religion in popular perception is the belief in a superhuman power, especially in a personal god or a gods entitled to obedience and worship. It is a particular faith and worship. But what is the pleasant similarity between science and religion? Both are the seeker. The science is the philosophy of science, and the philosophy of religion is similar. Religion seeks inside the human mind, and the science seeks what is the universe. It has been a hot topic for many years. From 1960, it has become the part of worldly events. There are a journal coming out on science and religion. There is an academic chair in the Stanford University and various universities across the world. And there are scholarly societies. Only thing is that today, if you want to talk about science and religion, you have to consider three things. The time period in question, whether you are talking in the time of Galileo or you are talking the time of today's time. Then the religion of interest. As our Vice Chancellor conveyed, this is Muslim. He will not bow down because his God is only one God. The views of the specific individual. For example, what are my views? So all the three things depends on how you perceive science and religion. What is my perception? My perception is And my daily prayer is, Natvam kamaye rajyam, na swargam na punarvam, kamaye dukha taptanam, prani nam arti nashanam. I am a student of science. I am a student of health science. I am a student of oncological science. And in oncology, I deal with the patients who are fighting day and night with life and death. The only fear in the human life is a death. And I have seen it from a very near corner. While studying my own science of oncology, there are plenty of occasions where I have to bow down to my God. I have to realize there is some supreme power. 50 years back, when I started my career, there were hardly 30 or 40 drugs to treat cancer. Now we have a battery of drugs to conquer the cancer. Still, our ignorance is profound. And this is what the march of science will lead us in the years to come. When I was just studying the cancer cell, as we are talking of atom to universe, we have an opportunity to learn about the importance of atom in the cellular cells, DNA, RNA. Only a small mistake lead to cancer. And the correction of that mistake leads to a best treatment. I don't want to go into more details of what science has done to education in a communication. Take a field. Everywhere science has done lots of marvels. Sitting in this particular hall, you feel fragrance of science everywhere. It has changed the world, but it has created many problems also. Because science is a tool, and any tool, it depends how you use it. If you don't use it properly, it can create lots of chaos. We are worried about atomic bomb. Pakistan is a small country, but they say that we have an atomic bomb. We destroy the world. Bomb is given by science. It is in a tool which is in the wrong hand. It can create lots of dangers. In a such way, we have got of problems of environment. Now the plastic, swachhata, all these things, if you don't use science properly, it can create problems. So it is only a tool. Something I would like to quote from few of the scientists. The greatest scientist of the physics is Albert Einstein. He says that science without religion is lame. Religion without science is blind. My religion consists of a humble admiration of illuminate superior spirit, which reveals himself in the sight of details we are able to perceive with our frail and troubled mind. There should not be any conflicts between science and religion. You don't born with your religion. It is your hierarchy, your father, your forefather. So be your have our own religion, but pursue for knowledge, pursue for science. We must continue and try to help our fellow human beings. Stephen Hawking himself was a handicap. What he wrote, although science may solve the problem and how the universe begin, but it has no answer how the it cannot answer what does the universe brother or exist, whether it exists or not. Swami Vivekanand, I have quoted in the beginning, but I will like to end with Abdul Kalam, only half minute. I wonder, Abdul Kalam ji says, and he has a very good book with Pramukh Swamiji. Those who are the student of science and also the wants to learn about spirituality must read the book by Abdul Kalam with Pramukh Swamiji. I wonder why some people tend to see science as something which takes man away from God. As I look at it, the path of science can always win through the heart. For me, science has always been the path to spiritual enrichment. In the Gandhi, we must stand with the Gandhi. In the essence, it is the search of the truth. To me, Gandhi practiced science all throughout life. And his Atmakatha is, it is Satyana Prayoga. It is experiment with truth. And he has preached all these things all throughout his life. He was never against science. He introduced in the Khadi board, J.C. Bose, scientist of the country. So friends, science is a tool. How we use it is the mankind, what it gets. Religion is also a truth for inside. Whatever the religion you believe, you can always achieve God Almighty. Thank you very much.